Hello my dear friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to describe teaching aptitude. If you like my videos, kindly share and subscribe my channels. First question, which of the following is at the basic paradigm in classroom teaching? There are four options. First option is learning paradigms, B is instructional paradigms, C is both A and B, and D is none of these. Then first option is C, both A and B. Next question. The primary requirement to become a good teacher is to have genuine interest in teaching, knowledge about controlling students. Third is subject knowledge, and four is good expressions. Answer is subject knowledge. Third question. Which of the following statement is or not true? First option, teaching is just an art. Teaching can be trained only. C, teachers are born. And D, all of the above. So none of the option is correct. So our option is D. Fourth question, which of the following is the sequence of different level of teaching? A, memory level, understanding level, reflective level. B, understanding level, memory level, reflective level. C, reflective level, understanding level, memory level. D, memory level, reflective level, understanding level. So here first option is A. Here answer is memory level, understanding level, and reflective level. Next question. Which of the following is an independent variable in the teaching learning process? First option, teacher. Second option, student. Third option, institutions. Fourth option, parent. So, independent variable is here, teacher. So, answer is teacher. Next, which of the following reflects the nature of teaching? First option, it is an art. B, it is a science. C, it is an art as well as science. D, it is neither an art nor science. So our required answer is C, it is an art as well as science. Next question, which of the following order are the three level of teaching? A, memory level teaching. 2, understanding level teaching. 3, reflective level teaching. 4, pedagogical level of teaching. Here options, which option is correct? So here option is 1, 2 and 3, that is memory level teaching, understanding level teaching and reflective level of teaching. This is the our required answers. Next question. Nowadays teaching is become more and more. First option, learner center. B, instructor center. C, group center. And D, none of these. So our answer is learner center. Next question. When the learner is self-directed, it is termed as A, pedagogical learning. B, andragogical learning. C, distance education learning. D, none of these. Our answer is andragogical learning. Next question. In the context of dynamic teaching environment, which of the following statements are true? First option, teacher is dependent variable, student is an independent variable. Second option, teacher is an independent variable and student is dependent variable. Fourth option, both student and teachers are intervening variables. And D, none of these. So our answer is teacher is an independent variable and student is a dependent variable. Student always depend on the teachers. Next question. At which of the following teaching levels classroom environment is required to be sufficiently open and independent? First option, memory level. Second option, understanding level. Third option, reflective level. And D is all of the above. Here answer is reflective level. Next question. The highest level of cognitive domain is first option synthesis, B analysis, C comprehension, and D evolution. Here answer is evolution. Next, the intellectual skills are reflected by A cognitive domain, B affective domain, C psychomotor domain, and D none of these or none of the above. So our answer is cognitive domain. Next question, attitude, values, and interest are reflected by first cognitive domain, B affective domain, C psychomotor domain, and D none of these. That is our answer is affective domain. Next question, teaching is based upon the mastery of first option knowledge of concept, B teaching skills, C decision making skills, and D all of the above. Where answer is all of the above. Next question, who has the least chance of becoming an effective teacher? First option, one who is strict disciplined, one who knows the subject well, C one who has no interest in teaching, and D one who teaches moral value. Here answer is one who has no interest in teaching. Next question, which of the following is at the teaching maximums? First option, A, 1, from psychological to logical, from analysis to synthesis, from concrete to abstract, 4, follow nature. Here, answer is all of the above. Next question, analysis means ability to break a problem into its constituent part. B, to combine the constituent parts, both A and B, and D, none of these. Here answer is ability to break a problem into its constituent parts. Okay, thank you for today. If you like my videos, kindly share and subscribe. See you next video again.